5 seconds to go. Start. Sir, the directorates of industries of the states, which are the implementing agencies of the programs of small scale industries development, are expected to ensure this. Therefore, the center expects the state governments to do something about this. As far as the governments are concerned, they are complacent about all this. They are blissfully silent about the possible steps they may take in future, at least to plug the loopholes to prevent such recurring eventuality. They are not prepared to do that even now. They shift the responsibility or pass on the buck and say that state governments are responsible because the small scale sector is within their purview. That is one stock reply which is often given. So, sir, this is how the multinational companies, big monopoly houses, etc., have come to occupy a place of pivotal importance and accumulated the riches in a very speedy manner by cornering all the benefits legitimately due to small scale sector. Now, sir, the other day discussion took place in this house about the amounts held in the Swiss banks. How this is happening? A study by the International Monetary Fund has confirmed that deposits in Swiss banks are to the extent of about rupees 1,300 crores, at least 15 to 20 times that money lies in the secret accounts of the Indians in the banks of Hong Kong, USA, and several other places. Sir, it is estimated that the total amount thus comes to about rupees 30,000 crores. This figure is again escalating at the rate of 15 to 20% per year. Last year, foreign trade was of the order of about rupees 3,000 crores. At least 10% of this cost goes towards secret accounts which covers trade only. There are defense and other contracts also. Therefore, we can very well understand what will happen in that sector also. Instead of the money being made available for this country, it is being kept elsewhere in furtherance of their own interests. It is not available for any national purpose and developmental purpose. Honorable Sir, I want to make a passing reference to the big business entering into small scale sectors and cornering all the incentives, concessions, and exemptions due to small scale sectors with a view to harness these benefits. Large houses have started setting up their own units in the small scale sectors. prominent monopoly houses and FERA companies have done so and are still doing this. Some of the small-scale sector enterprises are owned by the multinational companies. Small-scale units are small because of the limited resources of the entrepreneur. The definition of the small-scale sector, which is so changed as to permit monopoly houses to enter into the small-scale sector. Therefore, what I urge that the minister should give a considered thought to the definition of the small-scale sector, which is giving every scope to the multinationals to enter into small-scale sector and corner all the benefits. The monopoly houses enter the small-scale sector, and several companies numbering 290 are in the small-scale sector because of the lacunae in the definition, which is deliberately retained. I use the word deliberately. I am sorry if I am wrong. I may be corrected. I will be too happy for that corrections. Large houses entry in the small scale sector by virtue of their large resources, both technical and commercial places, the real small scale manufacturer at a definite disadvantage. He is eliminated. He is being annihilated. The big shark is eating the small fish. There is no turnover ceiling. There is no reference to the character of ownership. There is a constant upward revision of investment ceiling. I give a more glaring example of an electronic company, Westone, for instance. It registered itself as a small scale unit, but the amount it spends on publicity alone must be several times larger than the total investment of most of the small scale units. I will give one more instance of companies which are subsidiaries to big houses. There is a big list available. The minister himself must be knowing it. The government of India says that small scale undertakings which are subsidiaries or are owned or controlled by any other undertaking are not eligible for special concessions. Let the minister then identify those industries. The Stoke reply is, this is a matter within the purview of the state government. This information is not maintained by center. Let them not come forward with such replies. When I put a question, a reply came that the information was not maintained by the center. This was the reply. Is the government in the dark, or do they want us to be in the dark? In either case, it is not good for the country. Government have more than 50% equity. we have private companies where government have more than 50% of equity and their government has a definite and decisive say. Stop.